Plants provide us food, shelter, medicines, even its wood, and most important is oxygen for our living. Despite of all these gifts, there is one more very important function that plants performs every day, and that is to purify the air. Over the decade, use of chemicals, vehicles, and the items that releases harmful gases in our environment are increased. And during that time, plants always stand behind us and kept purifying the oxygen for us. So in this video, we will talk about this feature of plant, as well as we will take out the answer of the question that can plants detoxify or extract microvirus from air? So watch this video till the end. Right now, instead of taking all the plants, we will talk about indoor plants, as they are very close to us and affects us more than any other plant. So as we know that plants take carbon dioxide and in exchange it gives us oxygen, means they clear carbon from the air. But it is not the full story, because other than carbon, plants purifies many of the microbes, dust, harmful toxins from the air. Despite this, in the experiment conducted by NASA in 1989, it was cleared that house plants can purify the air from cancer-causing volatile compounds like formaldehyde and benzene. These compounds can come from cosmetics, cleaning products and cigarettes. And if we talk about some pollution coming from the devices, I mean radiation, so they can absorb some harmful radiation given by technology like computers and cell phones. But yes, they probably can't absorb enough of it, but they can reduce the health risk. But how the plants able to do it? So at the time of photosynthesis, plants take CO2, and at the same time, plants absorb many of the viruses and bacteria as well. Many of them transfer to the roots, and roots converts them into carbon and use as a mineral. Rest of the bacteria are extracted by the plants as the water droplets by the process of transpiration. And by this two process, microbes neither affect plant nor they affect us as we consume the plant products. Well, by this talk, it's clear that plants are biofilters, but to how much extent? So researchers say that larger and open spaces in houses will not make it so easy for plants to purify the air quite as effectively. So if you are living in some normal and least polluted areas, then plants always be a good investment for you. But if you live in a big and crowded city where pollution level always exceeds the red zone, then maybe you should go towards artificial air purifiers. But keep in mind that more use of air purifiers are not good for health, as they release ozone and can make your lungs weak. So which plants and how many of them we needed to purify the air in our surrounding? So we have a list of some house plants for you that you can plant in your home. They are English ivy, spider plant, snake plant, rubber plant, elephant ear, and weeping fig. And there are many more. NASA also stated that the amount of leaf area in the plants influences the rate of air purification. Means bigger the leaf, better the air quality. And if we talk about the number, then they recommend that you needed at least 2 good sized plants per 100 square feet of interior space to inhale the healthy oxygen. Well, that's it. Hope you find it helpful. How was the video? Comment me. And if you like it, then don't forget to subscribe and like button. Catch you later.